You can choose between a simple Gantt and a resource Gantt chart. For now, we'll have a look at the simple Gantt. Most of the time, report consumers want to set up custom zoom options, which they can now do so by enabling the zoom properties. You can zoom out or zoom in. In case you have configured additional categories or measures to be displayed, you can configure the name and the width of the columns. You can customize the data grid appearances property and have the ability to collapse or expand all the nodes to the level desired. Next, under the timeline properties, you can customize the look and feel of the header along with the header height, or even have the ability to disable a particular level of the header. So let's say I want only two levels, I could do so. You can fix the zoom levels at a design time. So let's say you want to display only 2 months at a time, you could do so. Along with that, you can also have a reference line for the current date and a text. For the data labels, you can either display the progress value or have any other value or category assigned to them. For example, you can have a task status to be displayed instead of a progress value. Next, you can enable the milestone to be displayed in the parent node. This way, you can view them when the nodes are collapsed. Apart from this, you can also customize the color and shape as desired. There are two options for alerting, either the status flag or conditional formatting, or both. Just like the conditional formatting in bullet chart, you can set your rule here based on any field or value assigned. Thank you for watching.